Hi guys, and welcome to my World of Warcraft Worlds of Draenor Zone series. Over the next few days I will be showing you guys Zones of Draenor. Currently I'm in the Nine Jungle introduction area where you first start once you arrive on Draenor. Right now I decided not to show you guys this zone since a large portion of it is missing and is meant to be an endgame zone. First zone I'm going to show you today is a Horde starting zone, Frostfire Reach, and is the home of Frostwolf clan and the Thunderlord clan of Orcs, as well as Ogres, and a place where you will build your Horde garrison. It is a snow-covered wasteland with several volcanoes and ice lakes that in my opinion really bring that epic feeling to the zone. Upon taking a closer look, you can clearly see sort of a look that would eventually become Blade's Edge Mountains in Outland. There in the distance we see Bladespire Fortress. I will talk about it a bit more in a moment. We will take a closer look inside. Let's take a closer look at Bladespire Fortress, also known as Bladespire Citadel. The fortress itself was originally a Bladespire Ogre clan's capital in Frostfire Reach, but later as you do your storyline, you get to take it over for the Frostwolf clan. It was initially intended to serve as a Horde capital city in Draenor, but with the release of Beta, Blizzard decided to scrap this idea and instead use the faction hubs in PvP Island Ashran to serve as capitals, which already triggered significant backlash and disapprovement from the community. I personally think this was a serious lack of judgment on their part. Just by looking at it from the outside and especially from the inside, it's clear that this should have been remained the capital city for the Horde and was designed as such. They basically changed this big real estate for a pretty small and crowded piece of land on some unknown island. What purpose is this decision supposed to serve? I don't really know, but I'm pretty disappointed. Same thing has happened with the Temple of Karabor, or you may know it as Dark Temple from the Burning Crusade, which is even greater shame because that place looks really epic. But who am I to know what they intend for these places? Perhaps they will do some scenarios down the line, or maybe change them to dungeons. We will just have to wait and see. But at least, I think we should then instead of these get a better capital city. Sanctuary type city like Shattered or the Lyran was in previous expansions would work quite well, I think. We don't need to have two, one epic city for both factions is more than enough. Anyway, let's take a look at the rest of this fortress and then we will move on with our tour. Thank you. This is where Duratan would be sitting if this was a meant to be capital city, I think. Okay, let's take a look outside for a bit. So yeah, like I said, pretty badass looking place. Too bad it's not to be a capital anymore. But what can you do? That's how these things go sometimes. Anyway, let's move on with our tour around the zone. As you can see, it is clearly one of the best looking zones, hands down, as far as I have seen, for me at least. We have great looking volcanic rocks all over the place, volcanoes, and also giant skeletons of colossi, which serve as capitals for Thunderlord Orc Clan. Okay, here we have Bloodmouth Lag. This is a level 100 area and it contains Bloodmouth Lag instance or dungeon. So, yeah. Looks pretty good from here. Pretty nice skyline there. And here we have one of the colossi skeletons. Here we have a capital of Thunder Fury Orc Clan, so it's another colossi skeleton basically. They build a capital around it. Looks pretty badass. Thank you. Okay, now we are slowly moving towards the next area. We see Gorgant there in the distance already. But before we go there, I'm gonna show you guys just a glimpse of another 100 level area. It is a iron works. This is where Iron Horde basically builds their guns, cannons and stuff, their heavy artillery basically. I'm going to leave you guys with the rest of this footage from Frostfire Age. I hope you guys liked this sort of an introduction into the zone. I hope I didn't spoil too much for you guys, and I hope to see you all in the next episode when we will take a look at Shadowmoon Valley on Alliance side starting area. So until next time, I hope you guys have great times gaming.